just back on the clay, and I'm going to work a little bit more. I was going to not do anything with the back of the legs because I figured the blanket would be here, but I remember now from my sketch that the wind is pushing the blanket up against his legs, so that's going to have to be there. Well, now I've got to prepare to add the blanket, and I'm going to pour foam in between the legs to fill in that area, because it's got to be filled in. It can't have a big cavity underneath. So I'm going to build a dike to pour the foam into. Now this is going to be more iffy because of the leakage. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to seal the bottom of the blanket with clay to keep clay to keep the foam in and not have it flowing down his legs, so to speak. Again, I'm using taxidermy foam to do this with. I've just poured the A mixture or B mixture, I don't know what one it is, but one of them. And now I'm doing the either B or A. This dark stuff is the stuff that you really have to clean the top of the bottle with. Because if you don't, that cap will never come off. All right. And let's get a knife or fork. We'll just go ahead and pour the other half in this half. Goes nothing. Boy, no leakage. None at all. Wow. How's that? Well, now I just sit and wait. Oh, right there. And there as well. Two spots. Okay. Oh, this is good. Yeah, that's gonna be nice. Filled up all the way. All right. Gives me some guidelines for wrinkles in the clothing. How about that? All right, let's take this apart. all in all, I'm pretty happy the way this turned out. Well, everybody have a good night, and I'll see you tomorrow. Now, if I can find my can to air. Oh, there it is.